My name's Eleanor.
My name's Archie.
My name's Isaac.
And we live in the village of Aldeburgh.
It's a very beautiful place to live.
But due to coastal erosion, some parts of the village has been disappearing. Come see.
There's bits detached off.
What did it used to look like around here?
The roads that did go around here, people were still driving on that about 10 to 15 years ago. There used to be two hotels and a cafe and the caravan park that is still here, but they've lost a lot of their caravans because as the cliff comes back, they have to move. And the people who had the hotels and the houses, they've had to move back as well.
How long will it take for this area to be gone?
If it carries on going at sort of 2, 3, 4 metres a year, these houses that are behind us here and in front of me, they will have to come down in maybe the next 10 or 15 years.
Hiya!
Hiya! You ready to see some cliffs?
Yeah.
Let's go.
How does erosion particularly affect this coastline?
One is the type of rocks and soil that we've got in the cliffs that are very soft, but also that it's very low-lying, so that the sea is able to make a big cut every time it starts attacking the cliffs.
Is this a new problem?
It's not a new problem at all. This has been happening since the end of the last ice age, over 10,000 years ago.
This is some sea defences here. What do they do?
What they do is they stop the energy of the waves. They break up the waves before they hit the cliff, so they don't attack the cliff as hard. Unfortunately, what that means, though, away from the sea defences, the cliffs are eroded a bit more quickly because the sea focuses its energy into there. We can see here it's made up of a whole load of rocks. They've been brought in from places like Norway. But as you move to other parts of the coast, you might see some big walls that have been built, and they're doing the same job. They're just protecting that bit of coast.
How does climate change affect erosion?
Climate change is really affecting how the sea is behaving and how much rain we're getting. When we look at the different cliffs and the types of soils in them, we can start to understand what happens when you put more water in there. And unfortunately for most of our cliffs, it means they start to collapse, they start to erode away a lot more quickly.
How do you decide what areas to protect?
So it's a really big town with lots of shops and people living in them. And because there's so many people living there, we can provide them with coastal defences. But it's really expensive. Unfortunately, in areas where there's not so many people, it's really important that erosion continues because the sand and the mud that comes from our cliffs goes right south all the way to Lincolnshire and down to Norfolk and right the way across to Germany and Denmark in some cases. And that helps provide places for animals to live. It provides defences for Lincolnshire so people in Lincolnshire don't lose their homes. So it's really important that some areas are allowed to erode and that we help people in those areas.